Hello and welcome to today's webcast hosted by the Sales Management Association. Our webcast will start momentarily. First, as a reminder, today's webcast will be recorded and made available for playback in the Sales Management Association's resource library. Sales Management Association members will also find copies of today's slides available there. We will not open the audio lines for live discussion on our broadcast today. However, we do welcome your questions and comments. Please submit these by using the small box labeled questions on the right side of your screen as part of the webinar application window. Today's session is one in a series of web-based Sales Management Association presentations that feature practitioners and thought leaders in the field of sales force effectiveness. The Sales Management Association is a professional association for sales operations and sales management professions. We provide our members with research, case studies, training, peer networking, and professional development. If you're joining us for the first time, we invite you to consider membership in the Sales Management Association, and we invite you to visit us online at salesmanagement.org. We're also happy to announce our sixth annual Salesforce Productivity Conference, which will host October 24th through 26th at Atlanta's Ritz-Carlton Hotel in Buckhead. Please save the date and look for more details about this event coming soon. My name is Bob Kelly. I serve as chairman of the Sales Management Association. Today it's my pleasure to introduce our speaker, and following his prepared comments, I will moderate discussion. Today's presenter is Vincenzo Borelli from Telecom Italia, or TIM. Vincenzo Borelli is head of commissioning and incentive for consumer sales at Telecom Italia, also known as TIM. There, he manages all sales commissioning and incentive programs and is responsible for incentive strategy for both direct and indirect sales channels. He has 20 years experience in incentive compensation and enterprise rewards software. His experience is cross-industry. He's worked in telcos, high-tech manufacturing, and basic commodities industries. TIM is a firm unfamiliar to our North American audience, perhaps, but is in fact Italy's leading telecommunications and ICT provider. TIM has a significant presence in Latin America also. It is in fact one of the very most important global telecoms today. So this is a very special treat for us. Vincenzo Borelli, thank you for joining us today all the way from Milano. And for sharing your time with us today. Welcome, Vincenzo.
Welcome. Good morning. Good morning, everybody, and thank you for being here.
Yes.
And my name is Vincenzo Borelli, and I am the head of operational incentive at TIM. TIM is a new brand for Telecom Italia Group worldwide. And I am glad to illustrate today our journey to sales compensation excellence. And I have three objectives today. I want to answer three questions you might have. The first question is about why did the team decide to start a transformation journey? How did the team undertake this transformation? And what is the content of this transformation? And I'd be happy if at the end of this presentation I have answered this question for you. So let's start. The first slide is about what we are talking about. I'm talking about a company overview, about a commissioning introduction, and about the story for commissioning in Telecom Italia Mobile. This slide is about what is team today, and especially for those who are not in telco industry. And TIM is a leading Italian telco operating in several markets with more than 60,000 employees. This is the main figures and context. TIM is present in Italy and in Brazil. In Italy is the first operator. In Brazil is the second operator. This is the main important figures about the revenues, about the lines. In Italy, TIM operates not only in mobile lines but also in fixed lines. About the employees, in Brazil, TIM is present only on mobile lines and fixed lines. The next slide is about the organization and about sales commissioning. And as you can see, it's a complex organization. And for this reason, it's important to understand that commissioning is located inside the sales organization. In most organizations, it's located in the finance and HR department. And in TIM, operational incentive and commission is located in the sales department to be more closely aligned with sales process and targets. About this target. The next slide is about the organization and the interaction with other functions of a Telecom Italia Mobile. There are a blue arrow and a red arrow. The operational incentive is a lot of connection with the this is the principal department of the company, with commercial planning for all the contest about forecasting and budget control, with sales channels lead for sales objectives and compensation drivers, with administration, finance and control, with finance and regulatory compliance, with information technology for data certification and evolution about the functionalities, and with Salesforce for incentives management and payment communication. The next slide is about the organization and about the Salesforce network. This is a circle. There are the blue, that is the breakdown. In blue circle, this is the organization of a pull channel, and the red circle, these are the organization of a push channel. This is the main important numbers about the organization, and there are, as you can see, there are a lot of stores, and also a lot of sales representative and telesales. To manage this sales force network, we have also almost 700 sales manager internal people that manage these. And the next slide is how I decide I represent the story. This is a story, it's a journey with a great tomorrow. Now I already read the titles of the wagons, but don't worry, we will see each wagon one by one, because we evolved from a simple to a complex commissioning in accordance to the market and the Salesforce evolution. The some years ago, and some years ago is for Telecom Italia Mobile 5 years ago, we have simple incentives. We have only P by price by quantity matrix, manual calculation, and only mobile, non fixed line. And for this reason, we have only simple incentive plans, a lower segmentation among channels, a low integration of commercial offers. We haven't bundled between mobile and fixed offers. And for this reason, The commission is very easy to manage because we have only price by quantity payment, and I pay for what you sell, and it's only about mobile, not and it's focused about only one channel, mobile services. And we use for this situation, if, we can use manual calculation, and we use Access or Excel to manage these incentive plans. And it's an easy calculation for an easier market. Then today we move from a simple to a complex in accordance with the market. And Salesforce Evolution commercial bundles between mobile and fixed, and for this reason, we have a complex and integrated commissioning. Now, not only mobile lines, but also fixed, and we have also numerous plans, a threshold matrix. And also, it's not only price by quantity, but it's important to manage also quality of lines and the flexibility of offers. And for this reason, we decide to move from a manual calculation to a platform. And the platform that we choose is that accompany our evolution is Beacom. The next slide about show the first capability implemented by Beacom and also the integration timeline of this project. The solution that we choose, the platform Beacom, is the tool used by my team to manage all type of commissions. And we choose Beacom because their capabilities were in line with our needs. The main benefits are no more manual calculation, few compliance, activities warp, it's very, very important for us because we have a time for analysis and reporting, and higher motivation level because people, my team change and have time to analyze the numbers and to produce a lot of reports. And also one and only centralized basket with all payments and calculation data. And it's also very, very important for SOX compliance and for internal and external regulation. And about the integration timeline, it was necessary 9 months. And this is also the on the line in this slide the timeline of the project. The first moment is for business requirement, 3 months for customization. Then we have 2 months 2 months for simulation, and then a go live of this. As I speak before about the platform, we use this platform to pay contractual fee price by quantity, but it's only the 10%, the 5 month 10% of our commission. The majority of commission is about extra bonus and free shows, and we use also Beacom to pay contractual price by quantity, extra bonus and thresholds, to pay also incentive for the internal sales manager, and also to pay the sell-in for all type of the channels, for the store, for sales representative and for telesales, not only for mobile, but also for fixed line. We pay every year almost 400 million commission per year with this platform. And the main results and benefits are we manage more than 100 incentive plans that are managed on a monthly basis by and monitoring several metrics, as numbers of acquisition, quality, for instance, instant churn is a KPI, for instance, and customer value. We are also a certificate by data granted by IT system. We reduce a lot of manual efforts, work a lot with IT department for all type of evolution and indicators and releases of Beacon. And tomorrow, this is a journey. Tomorrow we must change. We have to change because the evolution of customer strength, particularly digital, requires us to introduce new experiences, cross-channel, for this reason, now we study a new model of commissioning. This is a cross-channel and dynamic commission, where it's possible to pay cross compensation, where possible to pay multiple sales, where possible to pay value-based, and also possible to have a reporting, a very particular and a very particular reporting. And the future evolution is when we speak about cross compensation. And about cross-channel, we want to pay incentives to all the actors who take part to the sale. We want also to pay incentives to maximize the customer potential value. And also we pay incentives if maximize contextual sales volumes, and the key benefits are optimizing sales processes and incentives, maximizing customer lifetime value, and also boosting overall sales performance. The platform is always Beacon, and it is also necessary to review sales processes, and review these sales processes. We use also Accenture that review completely sales processes in Telecom Italia Mobile. We have also another revolution that is very, very important for us, is about to create a Salesforce communication portal. In this Salesforce communication portal, we will create in order to give more details about performance and incentives calculation criteria to sales partners. And we have in this portal compensation plan assignments, metrics for each sales operation, also overall sales performance over the period, and also important historical trend and result projection. And the key benefits are improving full monitoring of sales performance, maximizing compensation transparency towards Salesforce, and also increase Salesforce commitment. And now let's move on the last slide. This is a photo of part of my team. It is very important because the success of this process is also due to a team effort, because without a team effort it's impossible to have any type of result. And we have also some details about for further information about my email. And I conclude now my presentation, and so there are a period for question and answer.
Vincenzo, Bob Kelly here. Thank you very much, or grazie. We do have several questions in the queue already, so let's get to those. The first question is, can you tell us about the basic incentive plan for a typical salesperson? For example, how much is base salary and how much is incentive pay or commission?
We use this commission to pay the dealer. This is not in the majority of this commission that we pay for dealers. It's external people. But we use also this platform to pay internal people. The majority of commission is for externals, and we pay 400 million of commission per year, and is the 19% is for external people, and only 10% is for internal people. And for internal people, the bonus is 20% of salary. It is extra bonus over that time. It's also incentive plans that they manage on quarterly basis. And every Salesforce manager, every incentive plans, where there are five, six KPI, not only in it's about quality KPI, and with a target. If they mark the target, they have
okay, good. Thank you. So about 20% of base salary is available as incentive pay, and then they can make more if they overachieve. Vincenzo, we have a number of questions about the channel strategy. So perhaps we could have you simply tell us more about how the channel strategy changed. For example, one person asked, are more sales now credited to multiple channels like a retail store and internet? Another questioner asked, how was the system that you moved to, the BCOM system, able to facilitate this change in channel strategy? Maybe we would simply have you talk a little bit more about those changes.
The Salesforce network changed also because of the competition in Italy is very 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 tough, and for this reason it's important to a lot of stores, different stores. We have only 20 stores that are property of Telecom Italia Mobile. The other part is external people, and it's important because the store is a very very is near to the client, the customer, and for this reason we change also the number of these stores. And full channel is because is a channel is are present not only on the street but also on the mall and also in great distribution in the great distribution. Mm-hmm. And telesales and agents, there are a lot of door-to-door agent, but also at Teletels there are a platform of people that call the client and sell mobile lines on fixed lines. Mm-hmm. And this is also a agent that are located into the galleries where it's possible to sell something to the people.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Very good. Okay, so let's see. Our next question is, easy question perhaps. Can you explain the term sell-in? It was referenced on slide 15. I'll jump to that slide. Yep. What does sell-in mean?
Sell-in is the when we sell a product. We sell this product to our stores, and the store buy this product, and then they sell this product to the people.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
Sell-in is the commission, and the we pay to the store when they sell a certain number of products, as mobile phone, modem, computer, and so on. And there is we pay a commission, and also we pay commissions when they buy some numbers of these products.
Then, very good. Yes. Yeah. We often refer to that as selling to or through the channel. My command of Italian prepositions is wobbly, however, so I don't know the equivalent terms in Italian. Can you talk about how your new approach has helped or changed sales managers and how they do their job?
The sales manager change. The sales manager change every year because there are a lot of competition and they have a quarterly plans with a quarterly targets and. There are also different sales managers for a different channel. The best sales manager work in the franchisee and monobrand channel because it's the channel most important for the company. And for this reason, we have also a completely workaround of a manager inside the company, and their job is changed a lot because now it's important for us that they understand very in depth the incentive plans not all the incentive, but the incentive plans of the stores to manage these stores. And we change the incentive plans every month. And for this reason, the sales manager must understand and know all the details of incentive plans to answer all the questions of the external people. Mm-hmm. And now is the very important managers for a company. And it, for this reason, they are the only people that have a flexible salary in our company.
Interesting. Okay, a question about the two markets that you serve. The question is, are there differences in incentive pay for salespeople in Italy versus Brazil?
Yes, in Italy, the team is an historical and is an incumbent company.
Mm-hmm.
And for this reason, in mobile there are a lot of competition. In fixed, this is not the same competition as mobile.
Mm-hmm.
And so change the type of incentive plan.
Mm-hmm.
In Brazil, team is in a particular type of market with the growth is very, very fast, and is the second operator and is about the second operator. For this reason, there are not the same organization as in Italy about the sales force network and the so complexity as Italy is easier to manage. It's quite different. People, yes, there are the difference is the.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'm going to combine a few questions here about these relate to the number of individual incentive plans. One person asks, what is the biggest challenge of managing over 100 incentive plans? Have you ever thought of cutting down the number of incentive plans? Another person asks, has the new system allowed you to use more incentive plans? So maybe you can start by answering, which is better, to have fewer separate incentive plans or more incentive plans to target specific challenges?
Every type, these are more than incentive plans, depends also about the segmentation or the different segmentation breakdown of the channel.
Mm-hmm.
We have different plans for all the breakdown that we show. This is a plan for franchisee that is very different for a plan, incentive plan for monobrand, that is very different to for incentive plans for large distributors and so other. It's more than 100 because there are a lot. This is not a one plan amount for all of these.
Mm-hmm.
Franchisee has a different incentive plans every month because there are the main incentive plan. Then there are also LTI long term incentive. There are a lot of incentive for all of these stores, and also there are particular stores that are very important that have a personal incentive plan that is different from each other. And for this reason, the more incentive plans, because we have almost 6,000 stores and different between each other, and also we have 127 agencies to manage, and some of these has especially incentive plans very different from the other.
Yes, it makes sense. There are lots of different types of selling roles in your organization. Let's do two more questions. The next question has to do also with channels. The questioner asks, how do you compensate across sales channels? Are they weighted or based on a straight calculation? I hope that question is clear. If not, we can have the questioner elaborate. But I think what they mean is, do you sometimes have to share credit in multiple channels, say telesales and a store, or internet and a direct salesperson? And if so, how do you pay both?
Okay, and now we want to pay in the future not only the people, the stores that is at the end of the channel, but we pay all that participate to the channel. Mm-hmm. Now we have a lot of people that buy a product on the site, but they pick up the product in a store, and it's also we have a lot of people that call a customer care and then pick up the product, the line in a store. For this reason, we have a matrix when for every type of sell. We decide a percentage pay to a price to pay to all the actors that participate to a line to a sale. It is important because in this way it's possible to pay and to maximize the customer lifetime value, but maximize also the value of the sale.
Yes, good. Thank you. Okay, we'll make this the last question. The question is, how do you see the role of the direct sales representative changing? How has it changed over the past few years, and how do you see it changing in the future at TIM?
The sales representative, the role of sales representative changed a lot, and will change in the future. Because of the competition is very very high, but also because the offers changing, and now we have also not only we have a bundle offers where we in a offer we have a mobile offer, a fixed offer, we have also a TV offer. We have also a data offer, and for this reason we have a quadruple play. And for this reason, sales representative must understand every and must know every type of offer in a quadruple play vision. And so for this reason, when we take a customer, it's important that it's possible to sell a mobile, if it's a new customer, to sell a mobile offer, to sell also a fixed offer, but to sell also a TV offer as Sky for us, Premium Online, but also Team Vision, and so other, but offers also a data and a data offers, and in this way it's possible to reduce a churn of a client, because the client became a client that a lot of offers with the company. It's very. We want to reduce a churn, and we want to offer a customer all type of product. And so this is of the rule of sales representative. It's very important to manage this changing.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much, Vincenzo Borelli, for sharing your time and this wonderful presentation with us. Grazie mille, and we very much appreciate sharing with us today. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Okay, so I'll also remind our audience that our next Sales Management Association webcast is July 12th, when we'll host a session on sales messaging, managing quality, consistency, and effectiveness. You may learn about this session and many other sessions on our website at salesmanagement.org. I'm Bob Kelly, Sales Management Association Chairman. On behalf of Vincenzo Borelli from TIM, thanks again for your time and attention today. Goodbye until next time.